Hey, what's up, guys? So this week we did a team race, my buddy Mark and I. As you see him right here on the video, he is just moving along. But did a team race, IMSA 2.5 hours. Team races are fun. I had him do the quali and him do the first two stints just because he's faster. One thing you have to realize when racing in a team structured race is who is strong at certain things. He is far more consistent, far better pace than I have. So the goal was let him do quali. He got us into P2 to start. And then also as he started P2, let's have him build up the lead, have him build up some good times so that when I jump in the car, as you know, I'm slower than he is. Have moments where I can have great sectors, but I can't piece it all together, whereas he's quick and he can piece those together. So had Mark do the starting, figured I would come in later and I would do my piece, and then have him in the race so that just in case I lost some time, he could use his quick pace and his consistency to bring us back into contention. So overall, good result. Overall, really enjoyed the race. As you'll see with this race, a lot of things happen on the track, you know, pit strategy, fuel loads, tire strategy. Tire strategy is a little bit easier because you change tires as you fuel, so it makes life significantly easier. But again, I enjoyed this so much and I look forward to the next races. The next race I'll have here up on the channel, again, this is 2.5 hours, so you may not watch at all, but there's definitely some parts I'll pull out of it for some shorts. And then the next race will be at Le Mans, and I love Le Mans. I mean, it's such a great track to race. It'll be at night, and that'll be 6 hours. So Mark and I are definitely going to have a challenge in our hands. But again, we will figure out that strategy. We will, you know, do the best we can. And each week, we plan to just get better and better. My goal is just to have a more consistent race to take those sectors that I do well in, because his pace overall is because he is consistent. Mm-hmm. Whereas for me, my pace could be better. But even then I can be within 3/10 of him if I just piece together all those sectors. So for 2023, that is my goal, to get consistent at braking points, throttle, making sure I hit the apexes clean, and I can get that level of consistency. So I'm enjoying the multi-class racing. As always, I have some links down below. Check them out. If you're looking for some Moza gear, I'd appreciate it if you click on my link and order. That helps me and helps me get some gear that you guys have already supplied. So thank you for that. And I'll have reviews of those things that I do purchase along the way. Additionally, with that being said, my guy Matt Boyer at Simulation R Us, he's doing some really cool things, and I'll have some gear to review there. As well as if you're looking for some other gear, I did have an affiliate link for our digital motorsport as well down below. So I do have another video coming out about the upgrade I did to my PC, and how it's affected my sim racing and my frames and things like that. Reduced some bottlenecks that I did have, so we'll go over that and kind of have a video on that and what I think is the best path moving forward, and a lot of different things coming in 2023. So as always, I hope you enjoy the content. I hope you enjoy everything that I share. Go ahead and give me the thumbs up, turn the notifications on, and more importantly, subscribe. If you dislike something that I share, leave a comment. If you like what I share, leave a comment. Thumbs up, thumbs down, either way, leave a comment so this way I can get better, because I have taken some of the feedback from you all, implemented into the channel so that I can get better across all platforms and get better, because that's the goal. So as always, enjoy the race. It's 2.5 hours long, not much dialogue as I am focused on a team race, but again, I'll get better at doing this just like I have with everything else. So I will talk to you guys later. See you on track, and I hope that 2023 brings you joy, happiness, and a lot of wonderful things. Talk to you later. Peace.
If he's coming to pass me, I'll give him this spot back. You know what I mean? I'm not going to try to block him running.
No, I got you.
He's flashing me. like these LMDHs being so close.
Yeah, you would presume they would pull off. Oh, wow, you're catching the LMDHs. Thank you. Getting kind of close. You're coming up on a pack of GT cars. Oh. All right.
This could get ugly.
Yeah, just be as careful as you can. This is what makes multi-class races so much fun. Good job, Mark.
Just got in front of me.
Yeah, he might not have any sort of crew chief on or spotter. You would presume he would. You got some space ahead of you, so you should be good for a bit. How are the tires feeling?
Feeling okay.
Gap's now 1.3. You 1 and 2 have built a reasonable gap to us. Mark keeps separating. Gap behind now 1.7.
Mine's addressed to Ray.
First possible time to hit this crew.
Yeah, be careful. Looks like you may be able to pick all three of them off here.
Got past them all too. 3 second lead turned into or ahead of the lap. The guy behind is now 1 second.
Yeah, every time we have a gap, the GT cards, he ends up pulling closer.
Man, you guys are special.
I think it might be wild to, I don't know if you can see. I gotta focus here.
Yeah, I can see up ahead. You've got another three.
Like, if there's another big group, to maybe pit before coming onto them.
Well, there's another group of GT cars. It's about three up ahead. 4, 5, and 6. Looks like you have roughly about 3 laps until we have to refuel and pit. Let's see. Trying to figure out race strategy. Let's see. Once you get past these two, you have another group of four up ahead. That one and two are likely going to pass on this lap. I think it's a good idea to just box this lap for fuel. I'll make sure everything is set to full and replace tires. You're set to full fuel, 19.8 gallons, which obviously in liters, I don't know what that is, but it's full. And tires are being replaced.
Take a breath. Optional repair is 2 minutes 30. Because of the bumps, the curbs.
With your pace, I think that's something easy to make up, but are you feeling it on the when you're driving?
Oh no, I'm not going to stop for optional repairs. Forget that.
Looks like front left tire. A little more worn, but not too bad. Front left was 77, 67, and 67, so yeah, it would have been a little tough to get out another stint.
Got a faster class approaching too. You're gonna come up on a cluster of GT cars. There's three here and there's another two down the straight. Although it looks like they're pitting. Oh, none of them pitted. Good pass, Mark. P4, 5, and 6 just pitted. P1 and 2 just pitted, so any speed you can gain, now's the time. P3 just pitted as well. P1 and P2 just left the pits. P2 took over P1 in the pits. Be careful on the pit exit. P3 is leaving now. Back in P3. Good stuff, Mark. You got a lot of clean space out in front of you.
With the draft, I'm probably going to let him go.
Yeah, he'll have the inside line. No sense fighting it. Looks like Aurora Racing may have had an incident. Got at least another 13 to 14 laps left in this stint. You're gonna come up to about 4 GT cars here soon.
Like it did at the start, so hopefully I didn't break the car for you.
No worries. It's all good.
And if I'm talking and I go over those bumps, you know, I can't always control the way the sound comes out of my mouth.
You're all good, brother. All good. You just keep running these consistent laps. You're coming up on those GT cars here real soon. Wow, that was interesting.
Still in third, eh? So did the team pit, or is like another team pit, or did they crash? You said they had a problem or something?
Yeah, I didn't see where it happened, because we ended up in second place for a while there, and I don't see where they went out, and then all of a sudden I look and they were gone. So I think they may have had an accident, because now they're a couple laps down.
Okay, good.
Yeah, the guy in front, they started 25th on the grid. We start at 17th, if that sheds any light.
How far back's the next team? Fourth place.
They're about 30 seconds behind us. They're exactly 26.6 seconds behind us, so an entire pit stop. It's going to be a group of GT cars coming out of the pits. Looks like you might get past them though, so good stuff. Yep, you got past all four. Yeah, it was touch and go there for a second, but you caught him down the straight, so. Good catch there.
Yeah, all right.
It's a little more forgiving than a formula car.
Plus I'm getting towards the end of the tires, I think. And the car's all beaten up.
You roughly got it between 6 and 7 laps before we have to pit.
That was a good lap.
Gonna come upon a group of GT cars up here. Gap to P4 is now 32 seconds. And you make it two more laps?
Jim just told me I have 5 minutes of fuel.
Sounds about right. Because you've got an estimated 2.9 laps till we have to pit. So my thinking is two more laps depending on tires.
Oh yeah, the tires are okay.
Okay. All right, this is the final lap. Unbox this lap.
That's what Jim said.
Great minds think alike.
I'm flashing him. Is he gonna move? Nope. Jerk.
Would have been nice.
I don't like going down to 64.
Yeah. Coming around that bend, it's not the best either.
You got this. No pressure.
Have fun. Exactly. That's all I'm going to do.
So do I have to do anything?
When you pit and you stop, I'll just remove driver. You have to go back out. There we go. Cool. I'm in.
So I'm spotting?
Okay, yep.
Start spotting. Okay, good. All right, P4's just passing us now. P5's coming around. But they haven't pitted either of those, so we're good. Same with P6. Yeah, we're really good. All right, have fun.
Right. Let's go.
I'll keep the chatter down. So there's some GTs there. You're out in front of them, so that's good. There's two GTs, just get out in front of them.
Good.
This guy hasn't pitted. He's 23, so he's going to come in the next two laps.
Gotcha. Seem to take it easy on this outlap. Oh, these tires are so cold.
Smooth sailing in front, other than this car, 16 seconds, and then some more GTs. So.
Cool.
You do have a faster car behind.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Okay, just one car. Once he's gone, you're clear after him. You're good.
Yeah, dang it.
No worries. It's all good. I love this. This is good. Good fun.
Oh, tons of fun. You know, just want to stay clear of mistakes. That's all. Good thing he stayed out the way.
Yeah, I seen that. I seen him pulling forward, so I knew you were good.
Oh, mother of pearl. How does the hell?
Did you slow down kind of?
Yeah. Better be strategically.
car leaving the pits. We're racing him, so.
Okay.
Actually, no, I guess he's laps down. So we're good.
Cool.
Yeah, we're a whole lap ahead of those guys.
Telling you, man, you put in a banger.
Next GT in front of you is their number one.
Okay.
First and last, just like that. That really matters. But.
Yeah, we give them a wide berth, you know what I mean? Okay. That wasn't cool.
You're in the world.
And try to avoid him.
radio check.
Spotter, radio check.
The gap to Gibbons behind is increasing. It's now 15 seconds. That's your best lap in the session. To Gibbons behind is now 17 seconds. Coming up on a slower class car. That lap time was 136.53. Okay, Ray, there's a faster car approaching. Your lap time was a 137.28. Slower class car ahead. The gap to Gibbons behind is now 15 seconds. Coming up on a slower class car. You've just done a 136.28. The gap to Gibbons behind is now 14 seconds. Coming up on a slower car. Okay, Ray, there's a car exiting the pits, heads up. The gap to Gibbons behind is now 13 seconds. Slower class car ahead. That lap was a 135.59.
Hit the wall there out of curiosity.
I got a 0x, so I don't, I think it was more net code.
Okay.
Yeah, because it popped up, said 0x. I was like, what? I didn't even touch it.
It looked like you got it pretty good on the on mine, but then I didn't see the incident count go up. I'll stop talking.
Oh, no, you're good. You're good.
You're doing good. Keep it up.
Slower class car ahead. Okay, Ray, you've used half your fuel. Heads up, there's a car exit in the pits. Sector 3 is 0.6 off the pace. To Gibbons behind is now 11 seconds. Slower class car ahead. He's their class leader. Faster class cars are catching you up. Blue flag. Sector 1 is 0.40 off the pace. Blue flag. Slower class car ahead. Sector 3 is 0.49 off the pace. Gap to Gibbons. Behind is increasing. It's now 10 seconds. Slower class car ahead. You're a second off the pace in Sector 3. Blue flag. Yellow flag, watch out.
Should be pitting around lap 67, so about 3 laps left, I think.
Okay. Yeah, we're going to have to do a lot more of these. These are fun.
Absolutely.
You're coming up on a slower class car. The gap to Gibbons behind is now 10.0. You're a 10th off the pace in Sector 1.
Playboy. That was funny.
All right, Ray. We estimate you've got 5 minutes of fuel remaining. Blue flag. The car behind's a faster class. Blue flag. Gibbons, it's getting closer. The gap's now 9.7 seconds.
Hit this next lap.
Your last lap time was 135.19.
Yeah. Okay. Can't see how much fuel you have left. Where can I see that?
Oh, yeah, you can see in the black box. Yep. Yeah.
No, I think you can do one more after this one.
Okay.
All right, Ray. There's a faster class car approaching.
Oh.
Yellow flag, keep your wits about you, mate.
Watch out. Yeah, I was looking at the BMW coming back on the track.
Yeah, I'm gonna let him go by.
Yeah, definitely one more lap.
Okay. What's going on here?
He was off track, so he's probably got damage.
Oh, okay.
Blue flag.
Yep, hit this lap, and you're good for full fuel and tires.
Okay, thank you. Very little fuel left. Hit this lap, in this lap. 1 gallon remaining.
Thanks, Jim, but Mark already told me.
Coming up on a slower car. Half a gallon remaining. We're running on fumes, mate. In this lap. Box this lap. Gibbons behind is now 5.9. Box in 1,030 feet. We'll need to stop again.
Yeah. What annoys me, like I keep telling you, like where I can't get consistency, my optimal lap is a 134.2. If I could piece it all together.
Box now.
That's the dream.
Exactly. But that's, like, I just can't piece it all together. And then when I start to feel like I'm in a groove, there's a GT car or I'm being lapped by a LMD. Right. And what's crazy is you're sitting there so long that they start working on the optional upgrades or repairs. It's like, you're sitting here, we'll tape up a few things.
It exits clear.
All right. Cold tires. Yep. How much time do we have left in the race? Okay, so here's a thought. Did you want to finish the last stint on the same set of tires that I'm running?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I'm just going to put a splash of fuel in. I don't want to change all four, and I don't want to change two. So I'm going to keep the same tires.
Yeah, no grip. I did that when I was younger in my own car. I bought two front tires. Because I couldn't afford at the time to get all four. Had an accident. Back tires gave out. So.
Yeah, I don't like that.
Yeah, learned that the hard way. But. Alright, so let's race strong here.
Okay, Ray, there's a car exiting the pits. Heads up.
P5.
Okay. Hopefully he's nice.
Slower class car ahead. Coming up on a slower class car. You've just done a 136.75.
I'm just going to step away for a few minutes. I'll let you know when I'm back.
Okay.
Lead car's pitting. Sector 1 is quick. Sector 2 is 0.8 off the pace. Sector 3 is 0.5 off the pace. Track temperature's decreasing. It's now 88 Fahrenheit. The gap behind's increased to 3.9.
I'm good, not good.
Sector 2 is 0.9 off the pace. The car ahead's pitting. Slower class car ahead. There's a car leaving the pits. Blue flag. Pay attention to track limits, please, Ray. Faster car behind. Car behind is catching. The gap's now 1.7 seconds. The leader's pitting now. You're coming up on a slower class car. That was 135.85. gap behind is now 0.8. Sector 2 is 0.5 off the pace. Okay, Ray, there's a car exiting the pits, heads up. Time to get defensive, mate. That lap time was 136.43. P3. That lap was at 135.38. Sector 1 is 0.37 off the pace. We need to find a 10th in Sector 2. Sector 3 is 0.46 off the pace.
I didn't even see him behind me until.
Right there. He just lost. He lost grip. He tried to like turn or whatever. I think he was about to come in the back of you.
Oh. He, like,
tried to avoid you. And then.
Gotcha.
He's not totally out though. He just did a little slide.
He gotcha. Well, that's good. Don't want to wipe anybody out.
Oh no, you didn't. I mean, he was behind you, right? So, nothing you did.
Right.
Behind is now 2.4.
Well, that sucked.
Not much you can do.
Blue flag. Okay, Ray, ignore that fucker in the mirror. Stick to your line. Nail those exits. There's a faster class car behind. You're coming up on a slower car.
Damn it.
Bad luck, Ray. Come on, don't let him get away.
Nice avoidance.
Right.
Still hold on though, so he saved it. But hopefully he's cooking his tires.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. iRacing and tire models isn't the greatest.
Yeah. True that.
Oh.
The guy behind's reeling you in. The gap's now 0.39.
Gotta be kidding me. I'm gonna force you to stay behind him.
Make him do all the work. Focus on your exits.
Come on. Turn.
He's going inside.
Yep.
There's a faster car approaching. Last lap was a 137.34.
Defending.
Oh!
He's out. Well, not out, but... Yet another little wipe or skid.
Was that him or somebody else?
It was the LMDH behind him, tried to pass him on the inside and wiped out, and then kind of slowed him right down.
Gotcha.
So the LMDH did a bad pass. It's okay, though. We want him to keep on pushing hard. Sector 3
is 0.44 off the pace.
Right.
The gap behind is now 3.8
seconds. Oh, come on! Okay.
Unfortunately, we have to pit earlier than him, and so we have to take on more fuel, so we're probably going to lose maybe, I don't know, 3, 4, 5 seconds or something like that for our pit stop, I think. But
okay. Which is just interesting. Maybe we could have pushed one additional lap early on.
Starting fuel, we got to figure out why we didn't start with 75 liters because everyone else did 24 laps.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Off the pace in sector one.
So what we should have or need to do or figure out is start with 75 liters because we lost 5 laps. So he's going to do an extra 5 laps, and those 5 laps are. Basically, he can stop that much quicker because he's taking
right.
a lot less fuel, right? 15 liters, so he's maybe even like 5-6 seconds, but we'll do what we can.
Right, it's all we can do. I wonder if it's better instead of using like the VRS setup, use a different one but just copy everything over. You know what I mean?
Behind has now decreased to 3.0. Sector 3 is 0.37 off the pace.
I can't wait to get a new wheel rim. These grips aren't doing me any justice. Like, yeah, every now and then, you'll see when I upload the video, I have to just stretch my hands. Like, it's gotten softer, but it's just not going to be as nice as I would like it to be.
That was a 135.93. Alright, Ray, there's a faster car approaching. Blue flag. The gap behind is now 2.3 seconds. Blue flag. Sector 3 is 1.4, off the pace. There's a faster car approaching. You're coming up on a slower class car. Just done a 135.51. Sector 2 is 0.35, off the pace. That's 20 minutes to go. Okay, Ray, you've got 10 minutes of fuel remaining. Pulling away. The gap behind is now 2.7 seconds. That lap was a 135.00.
The tires feel like.
They actually feel great. I mean, I just did my fastest lap of the race, period, so I think it's pretty good.
Sector one time's okay.
Oh! What are you doing? Whew, that was almost scary.
Close call.
Car behind is reeling you in. The gap is now 1.4 seconds. Your lap time was 136.45.
Three laps.
Okay. No. Daggone it.
After this car, 6 seconds. You're good. Go, go, go.
Sorry about that.
All good. As long as we don't have the meatball.
No. I don't think I hit anything that hard, but...
back, there's some damage on the back.
You want to come in this lap or next lap?
No, you still got two more.
Okay.
Still got about a 20.
Okay, Ray, you're gaining on the car in front. The gap's now 14 seconds. P4.
Handling doesn't feel too bad.
15 minutes left. Sector 2 is 1.1, off the pace. in front is now 16 seconds.
One more lap after this one.
Okay.
Very little fuel left. Box this lap, please, Ray. Sector 3 is 2.0, off the pace.
Okay.
The gap ahead is now 17 seconds. You've got 1 gallon left. The car behind's pitting.
There's only 7 more laps, I want to say, but I'm going to put fuel for 8. I mean, we've got a nice gap behind us, so I don't want to shortchange us.
Okay. Makes sense.
Blue flag. We're running on fumes, mate. Pit this lap, in this lap. Half a gallon of fuel remaining. Watch your speed. The pit lane speed limit is 40 miles per hour. Okay, we'll fill you to the end.
Oh boy. That was...
Box in 5.
Good job, man.
Thanks, man.
3, 2, 1. Box now. Okay, Ray. 10 minutes to go. That's 10 minutes left.
Yep.
Nice. 8 minutes of optional repairs. 9 minutes of optional repairs.
Yeah. I think bumping into a wall may have something to do with that.
Watch, pit limiter wasn't on. Oh no.
Man, I was watching Scott when he did that. That was hilarious.
Stay behind the white line. The car ahead's pitting now.
These guys behind us pitted?
The guy behind's catching. The gap's now 0.10.
Let's see.
That's disappointing, but shit happens. Keep pushing.
We pitted just now. Tyler Beam. Mad Dog. Wait, Hocaine. They pitted... says lap 93. That doesn't make any sense. Hold on.
gap in front is now 0.48.
Yes, as they pit it three times as well. For some reason, it had... I was, like, in replay. It wasn't live for some reason.
Sector 1 is 1.4 off the pace.
Alright, let's see. So first place still has to pit, it looks like.
You're a second off the pace in sector 2.
There should be four pits, so I'm just wondering, the guys in front of us only pitted three times and they still have to pit.
That would be nice. See if I can find something.
I don't see how we would have lost the place. You know what I mean?
Right.
That lap was a 136.63. Sector 1 is 1.4 off the pace. Blue flag. The gap in front is now 1.2 seconds. All right, Ray, there's a faster class car approaching.
You got a fast class right behind you.
Flag. 5 minutes remaining, 5 minutes left. Slower class car ahead.
Yeah, the guy Tyler in front of you, I'm looking at how many laps he's done. He's done a ton. They last pitted on lap 71.
You're approaching a group of slower cars.
Oh, wow.
Okay, Ray, you need to pass this twat. You're losing too much time.
All right, Mark, you got him.
The car behind's pitting now. Push, push, push. We can get this position.
Good stuff, Mark.
There's a faster class car approaching. Fan-fucking-tastic. Now keep pushing. Guy behind's catching. The gap's now 0.7. That's 2 minutes left. 2 minutes.
You had a faster car on approach.
P3. Blue flag. Sector 3 is 0.7. Off the pace. Sector 1 is 0.43, off the pace. Okay, Ray, there's a faster class car approaching.
All right, final lap, Mark.
Last lap, bring it on home.
Gap behind's 1.8 seconds.
Third.
Well, what happened?
I don't know. I like it.
Right. I think they pitted. All right, just bring it home, and that's a podium place. Good stuff.
Like, I cannot believe you wrecked and you still drive across the track. How stupid do you have to be at the top of the S's?
Looks like there's some complaints going on in the chat. Alright, good stuff, Mark.
That's a podium.
P3, hell of a drive.
Yes, sir. Right on.
That's what's up.
Good teamwork.
Exactly. Oh.